So we're here at the Mighty Joe campground in Milton, New Hampshire. And this is a powwow that my adoptive grandfather started over 20 years ago, and he just passed the summer. And he honored me with having me carry out the Abenaki flag last year, and they had me do it again this year. So, you know, a lot of this is, you know, regarding the honoring the Indigenous People Days is curious, because I don't know that we've ever really done it. So, especially in New England, you know, a lot of people don't connect the fact that there's Native Americans, but it's partly because of the fact that there's been such shame around being Native. My ancestors referred to each other as gypsies. They wouldn't even call them Native Americans. So, and I have some Abenaki and mostly Mi'kmaq. And, you know, we had to even change our names and burn everything. And, you know, I didn't even want to talk about any of our bloodline until I knew what tribe it was. So, anyway, so this year I'm honoring Charlie True, who was our a grandfather to me, and so we're carrying on and carrying the. He was a very spiritual man, and so we're really trying to move forward, you know, and it's harder because, you know, we lose these spiritual people, and, you know, who do you decide who's the next person to experience these things, or who do we look to for these things? And, you know, they're vulnerable times, so it's just kind of keep the traditions going and keep the drums going, and hope it all settles out.
Wampanoag, Massasoit people. I'm here at the powwow having a great day, and I love everything about my people and their ways. My brother Hawk will add to it, so I'll give him the call.
Yes, hi, I'm Harry the Hawk Edmonds. I'm sachem of the Pokanoket Federation. And as my elder said, my brother, Braveheart, it's great to be here. And what do we think about the Indigenous Day? I think every day is an Indigenous Day. You know? But they finally recognized it after all these years. We've always been here, we'll always be here. And it's nice that they recognize that we are here. They recognize Columbus Day, supposedly, who discovered the New World, but we were here prior to him discovering it. But there again, it's nice to be acknowledged. We're a couple of old elders, a couple of old bucks, as we put it. We're called the brothers on the powwow trail. He's 82 years old, and I'm 81 years old, so we are a couple of old bucks. The creator has given us a lot of energy to keep us going and to keep the culture alive and well. And we thank you for sharing this here moment with us. And there again, it's great to have a day celebration for the Indigenous people. We say, in my language, we come off a war chief called Anawan. He was a war chief of the Massasoit, Usamequin, Yellow Feather. And Anawan was here to call out in battle, Ayutash, Ayutash, stand firm and fight. That was the war cry of my ancestor, Anawan. So I say to you people out there, Ayutash, don't ever give up. Aho.
Woo! dragonfly marten. I live in Maine, but right now I'm at the Mighty Joe Powwow in Milton, New Hampshire. And I'm having a wonderful time. This is a great venue, my first time actually being here. I usually perform flute and vend at other powwows, but today I decided I'm just going to have a lot of fun. So I was asked about how I feel about Columbus Day, I think, versus Indigenous Peoples Day. Anyone that asks me about that, I usually tell them that, yes, I know Columbus did not discover America. And I know perhaps he was not the most kindest person. But he did introduce North America to other nations and to other continents. And that's what I look at it as, not that he discovered it. So I am in favor of Indigenous Peoples Day, for sure. Thank you. So Deb asked me about why I come to Powwow. Predominantly, I come to Powwow for a spiritual renewal. I come to be with my friends, to gather here and celebrate love, kindness, forgiveness. A lot of things are happening in the world today that are somewhat horrific, and I need to get away from that, and I come to Powwow to truly just celebrate life. My background is that I am Native American. I'm Huron, Wyandot, and Mi'kmaq. I never knew that until about 2 years ago. 4 years ago, I found my real family. I am adopted, and I finally got my original birth certificate, and that brought me to my sister Nancy, and I found out that I am the oldest of five of us. I have three sisters and I had a brother, and unfortunately my brother Harold died the day before I got my birth certificate. So that was an incredible journey, and my friends kept saying to me in the powwow world, you must be Native American, your flute music is incredible. And I said, I don't know. And then I discovered my true heritage. I was brought up in an Irish and English family, but my heritage is really French-Canadian. And once I found out that I was really Native American, and I knew in my heart I was, that just made my flute journey even better. And I've just had a wonderful, incredible journey at Powwow, performing. I also vend with my leather work and my CDs that I have produced with my flute music. So I'm here. I love the beat of the drum, which for me is, as for everyone here, is the beat of Mother Earth. And I don't know, I just need to be here. When I enter into the circle, something happens. And I feel this incredible connectiveness with Creator. And that for me is what I really need. That's why I come here. And I just love the music. I love seeing my friends. And I love how we gather together a couple times a month. This is my last powwow of the year for me, and then I'm moving on to other things. I do craft shows with my music. This coming Monday, I'm going to climb Cannon Mountain. So I do climb. So I appreciate Deb interviewing me and letting me share my powwow world with you. So thank you.
A good way for all you folks outside that circle, like, come on in, stretch your legs.
of the Sovereign Abenaki Nation based in Thetford, Vermont. And I would like to congratulate the state of Vermont for recognizing this coming Monday as Indigenous Peoples Day. And I have every hope that next year New Hampshire will be doing the same.
Thank you. What'd you guys get over there?
Hi folks, my name is Tina Soft Walker Ames, and I'm Abenaki Mi'kmaq, and I'm also a female warrior. I'm attending the Mighty Joe powwow today, and I am so glad that they have Indigenous Day, and it's such an honor. It's mostly to teach the younger children of the generations coming up and coming forward with all their traditions and keeping them alive. Thank you.